Hi students, today we will solve some problems based on types of differentiation. So out of them, the first one is formula based. For suppose f of x equal to so root over sine of root x. So clearly, so it is a composite function. So why? Because so under root we have sine, and then in place of x we have root x. So here we have three functions are there, so root x, sin x and root x. Now how to derivative this function? So clearly the major one is, so main function is root x. Now differentiate with respect to x on both sides. What will get? F of x can be rewritten as f dash of x after differentiating. Now here we have three functions. Now first one is root x. So what is the derivative of root x? Sorry, we have three formulas. D by dx of root x is what? 1 by 2 root x. And then d by dx of sin x is what? Cos x. So first one is root, under root. Now cancel this term. So I have differentiate for this. Now what is the derivative of root? 1 by 2 root of, in place of x what we have? Sine of root x. Next, after completion of this, so we have sine of root x. Now derivative for sine. So derivative of sine is what? Cos of root x. In place of x we have root x. And then finally, after completion of these two, we have root x. So what about the derivative of root x? This 1 by 2 root x. So now over. So finally what we get? Cos of root x by 4 into so root of x sine root x. So this is the first one, which is formula based. Now coming to the second one, which is inverse trigonometric. So clearly inverse trigonometric functions type. Now let us consider one problem. F of x equal to tan inverse of secant x plus tan x. Now see, so how to find the derivative of this function? Clearly this is a composite function. So first thing is, we have tan inverse x, and in place of x we have secant x plus tan x. So clearly, so what is the derivative of tan inverse x? D by dx of tan inverse x is what? 1 by 1 plus x square. But in place of x what we have? Secant x plus tan x. Now clearly differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So f dash of x equal to, so for tan inverse 1 by 1 plus x square, in place of x we have secant x plus tan x whole square into, after completion of this, now find the derivative of secant x plus tan x. So derivative of secant x is what? Secant x tan x plus derivative of tan x is what? Secant square x. Okay, now so in the numerator we have secant x common, so tan x plus secant x. And coming to the denominator, 1 plus, so a plus b whole square, secant square x plus tan square x plus 2 secant x tan x. After this, secant x into tan x plus secant x divided by, so we have 1 plus tan square x. So 1 plus tan square x is what? Secant square x. So secant square x plus secant square x plus 2 secant x tan x. So secant x into, so tan x plus secant x in the numerator. And coming to the denominator, so we have 2 secant square x plus 2 secant x tan x. So common 2 secant x. So which is gives secant x plus tan x. So clearly secant x plus tan x and secant x plus tan x and secant x all gets cancelled. Now the final result is 1 by 2. So this is all about inverse trigonometric. Now coming to the logarithmic differentiation. So logarithmic differentiation. See, for suppose, let us take an example. For suppose if it is y equal to whatever it may be, tan x whole power x. See, so tan x is a variant, whole power variant. So in case of both variants, so no problem is there in the derivatives, so that straight taking log on both sides, now what will get? Now log y equal to, so we have log x power n is what? N into log x. So it is a very important formula. So log of tan x whole power x, now it is in the log x power n, clearly which gives the result x into, so log of tan x. Okay, now so log y equal to x into log of tan x. So we have u into v product rule, so discussed earlier. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Now log y, so 1 by y, and so here we have two functions, so logarithm and an algebraic. So first derivative for log and then derivative for y, so dy by dx. Why? Because we differentiate with respect to x on both sides, so that treat y as a so variant. Now u into v, so x into, so u v derivative is what? U into v dash plus v into u dash. Now x into derivative for log of tan x, so log of tan x plus log of tan x into derivative for x. See, now send y to the right side, this gives y times of x into, so derivative for log is 1 by x, which means 1 by tan x into, so after completion of, say here we have composite, one is log, logarithm and tan x. So after derivation of log we have tan, so tan x derivative is what? Secant square x. So now it is completed, plus log of tan x into derivative of x is what? 1, clearly. So finally what we get? Dy by dx equals to y is what? Tan x whole power x into, so x secant square x by tan x plus log of tan x. And the next step is, so hyperbolic. So hyperbolic differentiation. So out of this, I consider one formula, that is y equal to log of cos hx. So y equal to log of cos hx. Now see, so differentiate with respect to x on both sides. So what we'll get? The derivative of y is what? Dy by dx. And here we have a composite function, so one is log, another one is cos hx. So clearly first the derivative of log, so this is the main function. So derivative of log is what? 1 by x, which is 1 by cos hx into, after completion of this, so we have cos hx. So derivative of cos hx is what? Sin hx. The simple one, sin hx by cos hx is what? Tan hx. Okay, and then so next we have parametric differentiation. So let us consider one problem. For suppose x equal to, in terms of t's, dA cos power 4 t, so y equal to b sin power 4 t, then find the dy by dx. So we need to find the derivative dy by dx at the rate of t equal to 3 pi by 4. So now here, please observe this, x in terms of t's and y in terms of t's. Clearly, so x is the variant which depends on t, y is the variant which also depends on t. So that in order to find the derivative dy by dx, so first of all we need to find dx by dt, after that dy by dt, and finally we got dy by dx. So why I am taking dx by dt? Why? Because clearly x is depends on t. So that differentiate x and y both with respect to t. Differentiate x and y, so with respect to t. Why? Because both these variants depends on t. So clearly, for the first one, for suppose for x, this dx by dt equal to, a is a constant, put it outside, and cos power 4t. So we have here, we have a composite function. The first thing is x power n. So derivative of x power n is what? N into x power n minus 1, which is 4 cos cube t into, so after completion of x power n we have cos t. So the derivative of cos t is what? Minus sin t. So first one is completed. Clearly, finally what we get? Minus 4a cos cube t and sin t. So now for y, so we have dy by dt equal to, so clearly b into 4 sin cube t, and then derivative of sin t is what? Cos t. So finally 4b sin cube t into cos t. So again, so what we have? What we need to find? Dy by dx. So clearly dy by dx is equal to, so dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So dy by dt is what? 4b sin cube t into cos t divided by, so minus 4a cos cube t into sin t. So and this one square terms cancel, and for this square terms, so 4 gets cancelled. Clearly it is what? Minus b by a sin square t by cos square t, which is nothing but tan square t. So finally what we need to find? Dy by dx at the rate of t equal to 3 pi by 4, which is minus b by a tan square of 3 pi by 4. So tan 135 is what? The second quadrant, which is minus 1, but we have square, so that minus b by a into 1. Clearly minus b by a. Now the main thing is, so differentiate f of x with respect to g of x, another type. So differentiate, so one function with respect to the another function, which is differentiate f of x with respect to g of x, which is nothing but f dash. We need to find f dash of x by g dash of x. So this is the very very important type. Now see, let us consider one problem. So clearly derivative of sin inverse x with respect to cos inverse of root over 1 minus x square. Now see, so clearly it is what? F of x, and it is g of x. So here we have f of x equal to sin inverse x, and g of x equal to cos inverse of root over 1 minus x square. So clearly f dash of x is what? So straight formula, that is 1 by root over 1 minus x square. But here, coming to the g of x, we need to substitute one. So formula, that is So here if you substitute x equal to sin theta, then finally, so g of sin theta, so I write it as x finally. So what we get, cos inverse of root over 1 minus sin square theta. So if I substitute x equal to sin theta, then theta equal to what? Sin inverse x. So it is cos inverse of 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta, root over cos square theta is what? Cos theta. So cos inverse of cos theta is what? Theta. So theta is nothing but sin inverse x. So g of x equal to sin inverse x. Now the derivative of g of x is what? G dash of x equal to 1 by root over 1 minus x square. So f dash of x is what? 1 by root over 1 minus x square. G dash of x is what? 1 by root over 1 minus x square. Now we need to find the derivative of one function with respect to the another function, which is nothing but f dash of x by g dash of x. So that, what is f dash of x? 1 by root over 1 minus x square divided by, what is g dash of x? 1 by root over 1 minus x square. So clearly both gets cancelled. The final result is what? 1. And finally, so we have implicit function. Implicit. So implicit type. So just the problem be like, for suppose if ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0, we need to find the derivative, which is what is dy by dx. Okay, so this is what implicit function. We need to find the derivative of this. So differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Now clearly, now straight derivative. So for the first term, we have a into derivative of x square is what? 2x plus, and 2h is a constant, put it outside, into, so here we have two functions, two different functions, one is x and another one is y, so which is uv. So that derivative of uv is what? Uv into derivative of y, which is dy by dx, plus v into y into derivative of x is what? 1 plus, so b is a constant, so derivative for y square is what? 2y, and derivative of y is what? Dy by dx. So why? Because we have to differentiate with respect to x. Plus 2g into derivative of x is what? 1 plus 2f into derivative of y is what? Dy by dx, plus the constant derivative is 0, equal to 0. Now so take dy by dx common. So finally take 2 into dy by dx. So why? Because we are all having so 2s. So here we have hx plus 2 dy by dx common plus by, and we have f, and send remaining terms to the right side. So here we have 2ax, 2hy and 2g. So clearly it is what? Minus 2 into ax plus hy plus g. Now 2 gets cancelled. Finally dy by dx equal to what? Minus of ax plus hy plus g by, so hx plus by plus f. So these are all about types of differentiation. Okay students, in the next video we will discuss about some higher order differentiating problems. Thank you.